Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma anfa'ni bima 'allamtani wa 'allimni bima yanfa'uni wa zidni 'ilman innaka 'alimul hakim. My topic today is about unilateral opaque hemithorax. Common causes, less common causes, and rare causes, and differential diagnosis with some examples. The essential diagnosis for opaque hemothorax, we should look for the chest wall causes, pleural causes, pulmonary causes, and also we should look for the trachea if it is pulled toward the opacified side or remains in the central position or away from the opacified side, trachea and mediastinal structures. Let us see. Chest wall, the CT and MRI usually definitive diagnosis. Absent mediastinal shift, associated osseous lesion, like a fracture, chest wall, hematoma. Pleura, we have obtuse margin with the pleural interface, contralateral mediastinal shift, CT and MRI usually definitive. Pulmonary, acute margin with the pleural surface, mediastinal shift varies depending on the etiology. CT usually is definitive. Trachea pulled toward the opacified side. We have some causes like pneumonectomy, total lung collapse, pulmonary agenesis, or hypoplasia. Trachea remains central in its position, like in consolidation, pulmonary edema, adult respiratory distress, pleural mass, mesothelioma, or chest wall mass like Ewing sarcoma or Ascanic tumor. Trachea pushed away from the opacified side, like in the pleural effusion, diaphragmatic hernia, large pulmonary mass, and diaphragmatic rupture. What are the differential diagnoses? We have common, less common, and rare causes. The common causes include pleural effusion, empyema, hemothorax, pneumonectomy, and community-acquired pneumonia. The clues for the common diagnosis with for pleural effusion, there is contralateral mediastinal shift, atelectasis of underlying lung. We have meniscus line, lateral concave border where the effusion meets the costal pleura, and downward displacement of the hemidiaphragm on left side. For example, here we have a large-sided amount of right-sided pleural effusion with mediastinal shift to the heart and the trachea to the left side. Here, this is the CT of another patient, right? Large amount of the left-sided pleural effusion with underlying collapse of the left lung, and we have also lymphadenopathy in the paraspinal region. Here, another patient with right-sided pleural effusion with collapse of the underlying right lung. Here another patient with the left-sided pleural effusion with minimal shift, and there is effusion here with collapse of the underlying lung. Empyema, it is lenticular in shape, non-dependent location with a clear demarcation from the adjacent lung. We have the split pleural sign. Pleural fluid separates, enhancing visceral and parietal pleura. Non-specific for Empyema, it also occurs with any form of pleural inflammation. Haziness in the adjacent pleural fat, compressed adjacent lung and vessels, presence of gas in absence of thoracocentesis, and contralateral mediastinal shift. As we see here in this patient with the pleural empyema with CT scan, enhanced CT scan, and we have enhancing the pleura here and enhancing the pleura here, and we have fluid and gas in absence of thoracocentesis due to gas forming in organism in this patient. Hemothorax, high attenuation pleural fluid, more than 50, usually unilateral, history of trauma or iatrogenic. Spontaneous causes include rupture aneurysm, coagulopathy, pleural metastasis, pleural endometriosis. Here we see in non-contrast CT scan, heterogeneous and high attenuation pleural collection and pleural thickening in this patient due to hemothorax. Pneumonectomy space filled with a fluid within 30 days. Ipsilateral mediastinal shift, new or increased gas in existing pneumonectomy space indicate a bronchopleural fistula. Here we have a patient with a pneumonectomy and we see opacified left hemithorax and with mediastinal shifted trachea and heart to the same side. And we have see also the rib has been resected here and with regeneration of the rib. Here, a complicated left pneumonectomy with the fluid and air fluid air fluid level collected in the pneumonectomy side with shifting of the mediastinum and the trachea to the right side. Community acquired pneumonia, we have lobar consolidation or can be associated with paraneumonic effusion or empyema. Here we have patient with cardiac enlargement and coarctation of the aorta, and we have aspiration pneumonia involving the right side with air bronchogram with segmental bronchopneumonic changes on the left mid lower zone. Here patient with the pneumonia with left bara. Paraneumonic effusion on the left side. Here another patient with opacified of the left hemithorax with no shift and air bronchogram due to infection. Here another patient with scoliosis as we see here and infection with cystic changes due to bronchiectasis and collapsed left lung. Less common causes, we have endobronchial tumor, small cell tumor, non-small cell tumor, pleural metastasis, endobronchial tumor, whole lung collapse, less common than the lobar collapse. Primary lung carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma are the most common. Breast metastasis, colon metastasis, renal cell metastasis, and melanoma, and FC lateral mediastinal shift. Here, patient with 60 years old patient with mental retardation and with collapse of the left lung with non-mediastinal shift to the same side, and after bronchoscopy found to have a mucus plug in the bronchial tree, aspirated, and the chest X-ray after 2 to 3 days from the bronchoscopy re-expanded of the left lung. Here another patient with collapse due to collapse of the right lung. Here patient with CT scan and right pulmonary atelectasis with heterogeneous enhancement of the right lung with some effusion. Here another patient with complete atelectasis and mediastinal shift of the left and collapse of the left lung with opacification of the left hemithorax. Non-small cell lung cancer, extrinsic compression of the main bronchus from a primary tumor or lymph node or both. Small cell lung cancer, extensive compression of the main bronchus, bulky lymph node, metastasis may invade the mediastinum. Pleural metastasis, almost 90% of all pleural neoplasm, lung carcinoma, leading cause breast, ovary, gastric carcinoma, and lymphoma, usually multiple cancer-related benign pleural disease, and can be nodular, circumferential, and mediastinal involvement suggested of the malignancy associated with the pleural effusion, and can have lung or thoracic node metastasis. Here we have CT coronal, a CT scan with multiple metastasis involving the pleura, associated with the pleural effusion and lymphadenopathy in this patient from renal cell metastasis. Less common causes, rare causes, we have pulmonary agenesis, fibrous tumor of the pleura, and malignant mesothelioma. Pulmonary agenesis can be complete absence of the lung with no bronchial or vascular tissue, often associated with other congenital anomalies and resulting in neonatal death. Adults with isolated pulmonary hypoplasia, often asymptomatic, identical imaging appearance to the patient with childhood pneumonectomy. As we see here, we have the right lung and the right main bronchus and the opacification of the left hemithorax with shifting of the heart and mediastinal structure to the left side with absent of the bronchial stump noted on the left side. Another patient here, collapse, opacification of the left hemithorax with shifting of the trachea and mediastinal structure to the left side. Here we have some tissue in the lung tissue in the left side, and this is the right side, and this is the mediastinal shifted to the left side. And here, the contrast study, we see the main pulmonary artery, right pulmonary artery, and the left pulmonary artery is small in nature. Here, this is the differential diagnosis between pulmonary agenesis, aplasia, and hypoplasia. And this is very important how to differentiate the three entities. Fibrous tumor of the pleura, it is about 5 to 10% of pleural neoplasm, peak incidence between 6 and 7 decades, and approximately patient usually asymptomatic, and we have soft tissue mass peripheral within the pulmonary, may develop within the pulmonary fissure, and we have the CT scan and MRI appearances of this tumor. Fibrous soft tissue mass in the CT scan, we have calcification in about 7 to 25% with the smooth margin and with enhancement. In the MRI, low signal T1 and T2, we have cystic degeneration if there is necrosis or foci of increased density and enhancement. There is bleeding, and we have T1, T2 signal intensity depending on the age of the bleeding. Here we have large tumor mass on the CT scan, lobulated mass with enhancement and calcification with shifting to the mediastinal structure. Malignant mesothelioma most result from asbestos exposure and need too many years, about 40 years to develop. Can simulate benign pleural disease, can be nodular, circumferential with mediastinal involvement suggested of malignancy. Mediastinal relatively fixed with little or no shift. Associated pleural effusion may be present, and extrapleural spread, just wall, mediastinum, and diaphragm. Thank you for listening, and hoping to see you in another talk.